Hey, it's me, Cap Joey of When in Halifax. Welcome to our When in Halifax community. So anyway, our today's question is, what is the easiest way to immigrate here in Canada? Meron bang easiest program? So anyway, before we begin, please consider to follow us on our social media, When in Halifax, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and of course, consider subscribing to our channel, When in Halifax. So let's begin our discussion. Number one is there an easiest way to immigrate here in Canada? Is there any program to immigrate with your family here in Canada in the easiest way? So that's a common question that we receive. If you're talking to a program and you want to know if it's easiest way, then the answer is depending on your qualification. There is an easiest way, but again, it will depend on your application. So if we're talking about easiest way, from the word itself, I'm going to tell you that it is express entry. From the word itself, you can say that this is the easiest way because express entry. So you can understand that this is the easiest way from the word itself. However, you need also to consider your CRS score because you cannot invite, you cannot have an ITA or invitation to apply if your CRS score is less than 400. Make sure that your CRS score is at least above 450 so that you will have the chance to get an ITA or invitation to apply. So make sure when you try to go for express entry program, make sure that you already calculated your CRS score, and your CRS score should be more than 450. So aside from that, you need also a lot of prayers. You need to pray a lot because it's not a guarantee. So even though you have a CRS score above 450, it is never a guarantee that you will be invited. The reason why is every draw, there is a certain number that is specific number of application. For example, for this month, the express entry application that will be drawn is more than will be 1,500. And by sorting, by ranking on the CRS score, you are the applicant number 1,501. So from the draw, the 1,500 will be invited. So that's the reason why when you have an express entry application, you need to have a lots of prayer. You need to ask your family to pray your application because it's not a guarantee that you will be invited even though you have a very high CRS score. So make sure, Makap, that you understand this. The easiest way to immigrate here in Canada is the express entry, provided that you have a very high CRS score. And at the same time, it's not guaranteed that even though you have a CRS score that is above 450, it's never a guarantee that you can have an ITA. All right. So the second program that I can say easiest way is the provincial nominee. The provincial nominee, it is like our entry, my entry. So what is the provincial nominee? Provincial nominee is, it is when we apply to the province because the province is looking for specific skilled, and then we apply to that, and the province of Nova Scotia say we would like to invite this, and we will give them a provincial nominee. So provincial nominee, again, is the easiest way because you can be landed here as a permanent resident like us. So we landed here 2016 as a permanent resident, and we are invited. We got an invitation to apply to the provincial nominee. But again, this is an easiest program. However, there is a big however. You need to be invited by the province. And the question now is, how to be invited by the province? So the province will post a job position, for example, RN. They're looking for RN or nurses, registered nurses with an NOC 3012, and this is the qualification, and you can submit your letter of interest. So the letter of interest, you will submit that you are interested to apply, you fill up the application form, and the province will write, okay, we would like to invite you for nomination, and they will give you an ITA. So this is what happened to me, to my application. I applied for Nova Scotia provincial nominee. By the time 2015-2016, they are looking for nurses. So our entry here is provincial nominee, Nova Scotia, Category B. Right now, the Category B is closed because there is a new program in the Atlantic province, which is the Atlantic Immigration Pilot Program. So anyway, the provincial nominee is also the fastest and easiest way, provided that you need to be qualified on the list of jobs that they are asking. For example, if they are looking for registered nurse, only the registered nurse have the opportunity to apply for the provincial nominee. You cannot apply for provincial nominee if you are not qualified. So make sure that on the provincial nominee program, you are eligible to that program as well. So it's very important that you need to qualify on the provincial nominee requirement. Again, because Canada is a very big country, every province, they have their own provincial nominee requirements. Province here in Canada, they have their own provincial nominee program. So try to check every provinces. Maybe you are qualified. Maybe your job is in demand in the different provinces of Canada. So that's the second easiest way program. The last easiest program or maybe pathway to immigrate here in Canada is the student pathway. The student pathway for me is the easiest way compared with the express entry and provincial nominee. The reason why is, what if your CRS score is less than 400? So that's my question for you. What if your CRS score is less than 400? How can you apply for the express entry? What if your job is not in demand in other provinces and the provinces of Canada are not looking for your industry or for your profession or for your career because there is much of supplies inside Canada? So what if? So if you don't have any option, student pathway is the easiest way. The reason why it's the easiest way, because with a student, once you have an acceptance letter from the school, you can come anytime here in Canada, provided of course you have all the requirements and valid permits to study here in Canada. All the decision will be on your hand. So it means that your decision when to come to Canada, when to study in Canada, it will always depend on you. Because make sure that you have a school, which is you have a letter of acceptance. And then once you have a letter of acceptance, you can apply for student permit. From the student permit, you can now start studying here in Canada. Once you finish your course, you can now apply for PGWP or postgraduate work permit. So of course, with a student here in Canada, you can bring your family and kids as well. So that's the best thing about the student permit. However, always remember, not all school here in Canada are eligible for the PGWP. So my best advice for you before you enroll to any school, make sure that the school, colleges, or university, make sure that they are a DLI or school. The school can provide you a PGWP or postgraduate work permit. Always remember, not all school university are giving a PGWP. So you need to check the list of DIL school. You need to check the DLI school in the Canada.ca website. Again, for me, if you're going to ask me what is the easiest way to immigrate here in Canada, my answer to you is will always depend on your background and eligibility. So the program will always depend on your background. So once you have your own background, you have already your documents, you need to check your CRS score if you are above 450. So if your CRS score is above 450, try to check and verify if you can create an express entry and try your luck. And of course, I suggest also to check every provinces of Canada. Who knows, maybe there's an opportunity for you in the different provinces. Maybe there's a demand for electrician in other province. Maybe in other provinces, there's a demand for mechanical, for auto mechanic drivers, or for maybe for truck drivers, or for nurses. So try to check every provinces because every provinces are always different. If you're talking about how to immigrate here in Canada in the easiest way, I strongly suggest to consider student pathway. The student pathway is the easiest way because it's always on your own decision. It's always on your hand. So when the time where you're going to study, it always depends on you. So make sure that you need to consider these three different programs. And if you want us to help you, don't hesitate to message us on our webs, on our email. It's info@CAPUnityCanada. And of course, before we end our video, I strongly suggest also to use our free initial assessment tool wherein our team will going to check your eligibility and we're going to tell you what are the programs that you are eligible to. And if you want to study in our affiliated university, school, or colleges, feel free to message us because we can help you to process your documents. So that's it, guys. And thank you very much, mga CAP, for tuning in always in our CAP Unity. And always follow us on our social media. And of course, see you in our webinar. So if you want to learn more about Canada Immigration Forum, feel free to join us in our webinar every Monday, 11 p.m. Halifax time. Thank you very much, guys. See you in our next video. Bye.